But of course, there is always place for changes, as long as the person sees himself changing. He sees himself in a place that I want to change. But if a person doesn't want to change, you know, not the Zohar, not like Baomer, no, nothing. It's like a waste of time. If the person doesn't want to change, to improve, to enhance, to grow, if there is no desire for it, what the Rav says, go play golf. Go play golf. I heard the Rav many times says that. If you don't have desire to take the energy and to use it in your personal life to improve, to grow, don't waste your time. Go play golf or do something else more beneficial going to be for you. But it's a waste of time, Rav says. So we want to ask to receive this energy, this awesome energy. The way the Zohar talks about Lag BaOmer, of Hod of Hod, higher than Shavuot even. Hod of Hod, so many blessings that we can receive in this connection tonight and tomorrow. If we want something, we need to say, we need to speak to the energy. What is it that I want to use it for? Otherwise, what's the point? So I spoke about one main attribute, which is Yirat Shamayim. Yirat Shamayim, the awe, the fear. Because that's what Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Yirat Shamayim. That's what Moshe Rabbeinu, Eliyahu Hanavi, all the tzaddikim, Yirat Shamayim. Anyone that didn't have Yirat Shamayim, anyone that didn't have Yirat Shamayim fell. King Saul fell. How did he fall? He thought that he's smarter than Shmuel HaNavi, that Samuel the prophet. He thought, oh, I know, yes, you told me, but I'm smarter. In Hebrew, it's called Chochmolog. He was Chochmolog. Chochmolog. Shaul HaMelech היה Chochmolog. חשב הוא יודע יותר טוב. He told him specifically what to do, what not to do, and he thought he knows better. Chochmolog. And who else was a Chochmolog? Yerovam. Because Rabbi Shimon, there is a song that the Ben Ish Chai wrote. Beautiful song. Makom Bachar Bishmaya, Makom Bachar Bishmaya, Imanavi Achia. Rabbi Shimon, he chose his place after he left the world. He chose to be in the heavens next to the prophet Achia, Achia Shiloni. He was next to Achia Shiloni. Who was Achia Shiloni? Achia Shiloni was a prophet in the 7 BC, before 7 BC. And it was the time of Yerovam, the king. Yerovam, the king, he was a great king until he became Chochmolog. And he said, we can make sacrifices, not in Bet HaMikdash, outside of Bet HaMikdash. And he wanted all the people to believe him. So he gathered sages. Among them was Achia Shiloni. Achia Shiloni was a tremendous prophet. And he somehow tricked all of them to sign a paper that says that we agree to every action of Yerovam the king. We agree to all his actions. So Yerovam went from place to place and showed the people, you know, the signature of all the tzaddikim, among them, Achia Shiloni. Look, he signed, you have to trust me. Whatever I do is right. And he was doing the right things. He was doing idol worshiping, actually. Making sacrifices outside of Bet HaMikdash. Tremendous negativity that he created. Tremendous negativity. So Achia Shiloni he died, and he had, because of that, he had correction. So he incarnated when who came as Achia Shil, with the soul of Achia Shiloni, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. And so because of the correction, that's why he was in the cave for 13 years.
That makes sense.
So it's the
soul of Rabbi Shimon
Bar Yochai. It's Achia Shiloni. He was born as Rabbi Shimon. And that's why, after he left this world, the song of Ben Ish Chai, Makom Matza Lo Bishmaya, Navi Achia, he was in heaven with the Achia Shiloni. It's the same soul, Achia Shiloni. Because he was great, he was unbelievable, Achia. But he fell, just giving a signature to this king that became, smart chokmolog, that he said, oh, I understand how to do things, my own mind, how to do things. He found a way to trick everyone. And he fell, Achia Shiloni. So Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai came to this world and corrected with sitting in the cave, actually buried in the cave. Rabbi Shimon in the cave was buried to his neck with Rabbi Elazar the whole time. And of course, there is a spiritual meaning to it, that he was like the body that represents the desire to receive for the self alone. The body was totally controlled, totally eliminated, was totally eliminated. And that's how we could reveal all the secrets, because if the body was still dominant, the body is limiting. The body consciousness is limiting. And that's why there are many different restrictions on the body, many, many restrictions, not to make the body suffer, but rather to enable the soul to have the dominion over the body. That's in general. That's why many, many restrictions that, diet, kosher diet, meat, milk, this, many, many, endless amount of foods. Why? Because the body to control it, and fasting and all kind of things to not to let the body have the dominion, because it's blocking. Okay, and that includes also tonight staying up until 4:45. Until 4:45, it's called Tikkun Karet. Tikkun Karet is a correction or cleansing negativity that is in the level that a person needs to die. You know, the reason for death is a person accumulated curtains, spiritual curtains that blocking the light. And so at some point there is no light can enter to the person, and that's the reason of death. So any night that a person stays up until dawn and studies Zohar and Kabbalah and pray can do it, but especially in Lag BaOmer. In Lag BaOmer, because there is so much light, it's even more beneficial for the person to do it. And that's why we do it. We don't want to miss the opportunity to capture all the light, and also not to taste the taste of death. In Shavuot, we're going to do it again in 2.5 weeks. Another opportunity to receive energy. Shavuot is on the physical level, the level of the Torah that was given physically. In Lag BaOmer, it's the soul of the Torah. It's on the spiritual level, and that's why it's higher. The Torah is higher. Lag BaOmer is higher. Tonight is higher because it's the soul, the secrets of the Torah. The secrets.
So to connect to all this energy has to be a desire. What do I want? Otherwise, waste of energy. So Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai's main attribute is Yirat Shamayim. Because of Yirat Shamayim, he has anava. What's anava? Humility. Everything comes from Yirat Shamayim. Honesty, certainty, trust. Everything is from Yirat Shamayim. Everything. Think about any positive attribute comes from Yirat Shamayim. And anything negative, any negative attribute is because of lack of Yirat Shamayim. But there are levels. There are some levels that, worse than others of lack of Yirat Shamayim. Right? There are levels of, negativity. Levels of negativity. So when we ask for Yirat Shamayim, we get it. It's not an option for the universe. Hakol b'yidei shamayim chutz mirat shamayim. When we ask to have Yirat Shamayim, it's something that we have an opportunity to pray for every day. A person can have Yirat Shamayim and God forbid lose it, right? But when a person prays for it every day, when a person prays for it, then it's his. He has it. When a person prays for it, the fact that the moment that he prays for it, he has it. They don't need to calculate anything upstairs. You deserve it, you don't deserve it. You have it. And the reason why I talk about it, because we can open the Zohar and study something. Wow, amazing. Amazing what? Amazing how? Amazing life has to be amazing. Not information. Not teaching. Life has to be amazing. Person has to live his life in an amazing way. In a way that he sees, wow, it's amazing. Life is amazing. If not, something is wrong. Something is wrong with the connection. With the connection to the Zohar, to Rabbi Shimon, to the light. What's wrong? Yirat Shamayim. Yirat Shamayim is wrong. Emunah lemala min hadat. Belief, certainty, trust. Emunah in the heart. Belief, simple faith. Simple faith is higher than all the wisdom. Higher than all the wisdom. Higher. You know, there is a story of Elisha. It was a story of Rabbi Meir and Rabbi Akiva, great sages. That the person, Elisha ben Avuya, that he got confused. He had so much wisdom that at some point he got confused. And he became from a person that was totally connected to a non-believer. Lack of certainty, confused and everything. But he still had a lot of wisdom. That Rabbi Meir was studying from him. Rabbi Meir, great Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes, was studying from Elisha Acher. And Elisha Acher, with all the great wisdom, he had wisdom that people cannot even imagine how much wisdom he had. And yet, he lost everything. But Rabbi Meir was studying from him because he had the ability, Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes, it says, Tocho achal klipato zarak. He ate the inside, the fruit, and the shell. He could distinguish between the good and bad. So he could take the good from him. Could take the good. He didn't, completely removed him from his life. He still saw him as a, scholar that I can study from. But he had the ability to distinguish the good from the bad. So the point is that it's never about the wisdom. It's about the emunah. It's about the heart. It's about the desire to enhance the connection to the light. It's about the desire to enhance the connection to Rabbi Shimon, the power of Rabbi Shimon, the power of the Zohar. The Zohar has power. It's beyond the wisdom. It's beyond logic. The Zohar has power that is beyond any explanation. You cannot explain the power of the Zohar. That's why mezuzah that we put on the post door, mezuzah has to do with emunah. But not only mezuzah, everything has to do with belief. Some people don't believe, they don't do anything. They say, atheists, don't believe in anything. So they don't do anything. Which one is better, to be atheist or to be, and not to have emunah, not to have yirat shamayim? To be atheist is better. Why? Because atheist has a chance.
Right.
One day he's gonna wake up.
That's how I got Chris to study, because he was like, oh.
One day he's gonna wake up and say, wow, I didn't know that. I wasn't introduced to this. I was not.
Yeah, versus a strong beliefs.
Exactly.
They want to know the.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they have a strong will.
They have strong beliefs.
Yeah.
So, this week I saw a movie, a famous singer in Israel that don't believe in God. And they give the show a big guest. Yeah, the religious. And so after the show, he got the flash. But he thought the religious are not the problem, and he stopped crying, and he make a song, his song sing for them in the middle of the show.
Ah, wow.
So after the show, he opened his phone, he see 400 messages from people in Mashal, each one
the most religious.
They tell him, thank you for your support and for your love. And he did say, I start to believe in God, but he said, I'm not the problem. And we need to stop fighting.
Okay. He has a person that is atheist, not part of the of anything, is a it's like a clean
slate
that has a chance one day to be connected, versus somebody that is here, there. That's why Rebecca, yeah, in many ways true, many ways it's true. So one, wow, Yosef, So emunah, to ask for yirat shamayim, and we did yirat shamayim with a sense of seeing the light everywhere. What is the Kabbalist? What is the Kabbalist? Like the Ari, like the Rav. They see the light in everything. And they see also where there is no light. Yeah, they see also the where there is no light. Not just the light. They're not. Yeah, but they see also where to stay away from. And, Yeah. Yeah, because there are two forces, duality, light and darkness. So yira shamayim. So yira, when a person does yira, he sees and he's tuned to not doing the wrong things. What's the wrong things? The wrong things in Hebrew, it's called avera. What's avera? Avera is like a sin, but it's not really a sin. Kabbalistically, it's like to transfer energy to the other side. And I also heard from Yosef's class this week, he was telling his teacher, the rabbi, Avera is Avar, hey, Avar Hashem, that the person when he does something negative. What?
Passing over God, passing over his hand, but don't do this, but do the
other. Avar Hashem, yeah. Yeah. Passing over God. That's a revelation. I never heard. Yeah, exactly. The GPS, a little bit.
I just had a dream about that.
Yeah, you know, I remember many years ago, somebody, student in a lay center, he came, and it was the evening time where the Rav was praying Arvit, you know, with the, and he started to talk to me and a few others, and he said, you know, I couldn't sleep for 1 week, couldn't sleep, you know, for 1 minute, couldn't fall asleep. So he said, you know, I want to ask the Rav. That time, the center was smaller.
Yeah.
So people could have, you know, access to ask the Rav, you know, personal questions. So the Rav finished the prayer and he went up to the Rav and he came back and we asked him, what did the Rav tell you? And he said, the Rav told me that in the airplane, if the GPS, if there is 1 millimeter off, the airplane is landing in a completely different place. We asked him, what else did the Rav say? He said, nothing. He said that and walked away.
I got
it. Yeah.
I mean,
you know, the head. What is Yirah? Yirah is to see. It's to, the light is here. How could I allow myself to do something in front of the light? How could I, unless a person wants to do it purposely. Like he has something against,
yeah,
you know, against. So that some people has against God, blaming God, even, you know, subconsciously. They don't know it consciously, but subconsciously do it against God, punish God. That's what they think. It's not a game. It's a very serious matter, you know, to act like that. You know, and in many, many ways, that's a lack of Yirat Shamayim. But Yirat Shamayim is the ingredient for what the way we want to live. We want to have humility. Who doesn't want to be humble? You know, arrogant, it's like a flash and a crash. Nobody really wants to be in that place, you know, arrogant and show off and selfish and greedy and all that. Nobody wants that. Nobody. People want peace of mind. Ask anybody, what do you want? Peace of mind, tranquility, love. How do you get all this? It's from inside. It's the ingredient is Yirat Shamayim. Yirat Shamayim. And so Yirat Shamayim, it's to makes a person be in the right places and the right time, make the right decisions, meet the right people, attract the right people. Everything is Yirat Shamayim. And so it's together with Emunah. Yirat Shamayim is Emunah. So the same way that Mezuzah is not a Jewish symbol. Mezuzah, it's a tool. But this tool has nothing to do with anything but Emunah. That has to do with Emunah, that it's an antenna, a protection tool, mezuzah. Same Rabbi Shimon. Rabbi Shimon and the Zohar, it's all about Emunah. Ask most of the people that believe in Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, anything from the Zohar, they know nothing. They never opened the Zohar. But they have Emunah in Rabbi Shimon. They have Emunah. Of course, it's more powerful to open the Zohar, but I'm talking about, you know, from some countries that the Zohar wasn't available, but They grew up with the emunah. It's built in, you know, belief system. The Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai is the, you know, you can rely on him. You can ask for assistance, for help, for blessings. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, yeah.
That's all I do.
Yeah.
That's it.
Especially the talks to Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai.
Yeah.
I told Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai.
Yeah. Yeah. It's all about that. It's all about emunah. On the other hand, there are some people that has, you know, knowledge from the Zohar. Information from the Zohar. They know a lot, but the zero emunah. Those that have emunah and know, of course, the ultimate is to have emunah and wisdom. That's a person should work on both of them, emunah and study Zohar. And study and try to understand and more and more and more and invest more and more time, of course. But the theoretical information doesn't make the connection.
It seems like almost impossible to study the Zohar and not have it. I know what you're saying, yeah. But if you're that close to the Zohar and you're studying it.
You're right, because there is something that is called Ta'amu Uru Kitov Hashem. Mishelo lishma yavo lishma, which means that the study of Zohar and Torah is the power, but when a person really invests energy, time, not just once in a while we open Zohar, when a person is investing, is making effort to understand, then he's going to get to taste of the light, and it's going to have emunah, it's going to have the connection.
Yeah. Like, studying Zohar only hard and not like having any lines in, like, it's like painting a picture without knowing what color it was. You don't know what you're studying about, but like you're studying, but you don't know what it really means.
Right. Because the wisdom is the wisdom of life. The Zohar and Kabbalah, the wisdom of life. So in both ways, a person needs to invest in emunah, to ask every day, and the wisdom also, to invest, to make an effort, to try to understand, the Zohar. Not just to have emunah, blind emunah. Has to be together. But always emunah lemala min adam. And Yirat Shamayim. So I'll read the section from the Zohar. The best way to connect. The Aramaic of the Zohar is the most powerful way to connect to the light. More than any prayer, more than any book, the Zohar itself. More than, I'm saying anything, Gemara, Mishnah. נפלו רבי אליעזר ורבי אבא קמה, עד אחי ואחי לחמו לה, קמו והסתכלו לכל סיטרים ולא חמו לה, ידבו וחו ולא אכילו למללה דה לדה, לבטר שאתה אמר רבי אבא, ודאי עד את הנינן, ובכל אורך עד את צדיקה יעזלין ומילוי דוריית הבינאריו, לינון זכאים דהו עלמת יען לגביון, ודאי דה הוא רב אמנונה סבא, דעתה לגבל מהו עלמה, וגלה לן מילין אילין, ועד לן השתמודע בה, עזה להם את כסה מינן, קמו ועבו בעו למיתן לחמרי ולא עזלו, בעו למיתן ולא עזלו, דחילו והנחו לון לחמרי, ועד יומה עבו קרן להו אתר דוח דחמרי. So this is a section from the introduction to the Zohar that I recommend everyone to read the introduction. It's very interesting. It's volume one of the Zohar, volume one. Probably my favorite section of the Zohar, really. It's clear teaching, very, very powerful. In many ways, you study it and you feel like elevated. unlike other places in the Zohar that are a little bit difficult to understand, but the entire prologue is amazing teaching. So I recommend everyone to study it. Really part of the commitment to connection to the Zohar is to make it as a part of our daily spiritual routine. So to have a goal, like to read it in order. I most of the time read the Zohar from beginning to end, whether it takes me a year or 5 years or 7 years, but depends how I read it. Sometimes I read only the Aramaic, sometimes the Aramaic and the Sulam together, section in Aramaic, so, but I read it in order. So this way, it's easier for me to read every day, and I want to read as much as possible, every opportunity. Why? Because I can't wait to finish it. You know why? Because every time I finish it, what do we have? Sushi. We make what we call siyum. We make a celebration. So we get sushi and great food. That's why I can't wait. So I read, you know, as much as I can. But it's a very powerful way. With the sulam, with the introduction, it's also to connect to Rav Ashlag. Connect to Rav Ashlag and Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai together. I'm saying to connect again because it's about connecting to them, connecting to Rabbi Shimon, connecting to Rav Ashlag, connecting to Tzadikim. It's more powerful than anything. It's more powerful than anything. Rav Ashlag writes about it clearly to his students. You know, the connection, the love, and the feeling, you know, inside, that's what makes the difference. And that's what we want to awaken. We want to awaken this. We want to pray for it. We pray for it, we'll get it. We don't pray for it, we don't get it. We don't have it. We pray for it every day. Yirat Shamayim. Everything comes from there. Everything from Yirat Shamayim. Everything that we want. All the blessings from Yirat Shamayim. And so, and you know, all the stories of tzaddikim, how they had, you know, tremendous miracles. If it's Daniel the prophet, if it's Abraham the patriarch, if it's Rabbi Shimon, all the big tests, all the big miracles, it's because of Yirat Shamayim. To see, to be able to see. And that's why it's also related to Natan Eino Bo, that Rabbi Shimon looked. It's to see the sight. Why the sight? The sight is in the level of Chokhmah. It's the highest level, the level of Chokhmah that makes the connection to things. Rabbi Shimon Natan Eino Bo. He saw and things happened. To see the light, things happen. To see the light all the time. To be in this place that I want to see the light all the time next to me. That's Rabbi Shimon. That's the greatness. And that's why he could see Eliyahu and Moses. What does it say in the Gemara? If a normal person would see, you know, a little bit of what's going on, he would faint out of fear. From protection, that the universe protecting us, that we don't see what's really going on. We see physical for protection. Because what's happening really in the beyond the sight, the physical sight, what's happening is beyond, you know, anything that we can you know, comprehend. And that's why we don't see. So tzaddikim can see. Why can they can see? Because they see the light. It's all connected. It's all starting with Yirat Shamayim. Everything. Everything from Yirat Shamayim. Everything. Yirat Shamayim. Person that has Yirat Shamayim. He has this fear. He's humble. He's shy. He's no chutzpan. You know, the absence of that is to be chutzpan. Yeah. Chutzpan is to allow, you know, to do whatever. We justify things.
That's chod, right? Chod of chod, the humbleness.
Yeah. So same power of Kriyat Yam Suf, splitting of the Red Sea. Tremendous power, tremendous energy. Exactly. Yirat Shamayim, that's the energy of tonight. That's Rabbi Shimon. Yirat Shamayim. The light, what else? Only the light. What else exists? Not even the body, covered this body, not even the body. Nothing, only the light. To see the light. Yeah, that's what we want. See the light. Okay. When a person has Yirat Shamayim, he can argue with God. Like Rabbi Shimon also. But when a person doesn't have Yirat Shamayim, has no say. Yeah. Abraham, Moses, they all argued with God. All the tzaddikim argued. They argue for the people.
Yeah.
They care for people. By the way, today I read the newspaper that it happens all the time, but it's something that from the morning they felt so bad for me.
Do you like yours?
Very much.
Yeah. Group of immigrants will try to immigrate from Africa on a boat to Spain, to the Canary Islands. And they got lost in the ocean on the boat, you know, they lost
the sea.
They ran out of gas or something. And they were there for 24 days. And so most of them died. Only 2 or 3 survived.
I give the helicopter like there. Because they're like,
because
they think it's like some.
You know, this is the
news. It's 2020.
From the beginning of the year, 450 people died.
I tell them, I'm sorry, I'm not spoiled.
What did they try? To have
like,
their normal life, you know? Not to be part of all the wars and the hunger. Yeah. You know, people try to be. People,
where is it?
You know, to live life.
How's my sense of car?
Is he like it?
And they died on the way to
which car?
Very painful. Sad, you know.
Sad.
Oh, like in general?
It's going on for years.
Have you seen his car?
To Italy, Spain,
just asking how it is in general.
They go, they get
so he had a car
because of overloaded.
And the lease was up.
You know,
from
people.
The swap of
so I remember the rods.
Yes.
So we
like.
Which would you have a better chance
like visually and
sort of elevating?
Like we put an actual chain together. It's a guy thing to do.
So I mean,
and then you gave it back.
You have to look
at
the meeting.
Yeah, of course. And then, has to do a lot with
yes, we did
and
that.
I have
wanted
to say
charger,
that because otherwise it's so painful. It's hard to bear.
It's like a four-door.
Yeah.
Dodge Charger.
You really don't want anybody to have good feet.
So
know,
there's a V8 and then a V6.
In a way, it's self-created.
So it's
a
new idea.
It's so good.
What a good one.
V8 is like...
Yeah, also, yes.
Like a low version of it, basic model. So
okay,
we had a vision
four,
of like
right?
having
because
a project
where
to modify it to make it
yeah.
So you could put like, this is a more serious
we're going to do our vid now.
Israeli guy.
Israel. From Israel?
No, his name was Israel. He's Israeli. The dealership is in Orange County.
No,
online. They have amazing deals. Amen.
Amidah, individual connection is one of my soul. They did, I'm not sure for that much. Please,
gather.
Moskva.
Amen. Gracias. delivered to them, or a black full set of sacred Zohars delivered to them.